George Anderson in the band From Hell, and we are here at Skyline Studios. We just finished tracking drums with Paul Bostaph.
From Hell is a dark concept band. It is a heavy metal band with a horror theme to it. This first album, called Ascent From Hell, is about a corpse that wakes up in hell and finds out he must return to Earth to find his soul that still lives on in another body and drag it back to hell. From Hell is a project I started about 7 years ago. When I started writing it and developing the concept story, I did it with the intent of writing very epic songs, very long and epic songs. I wasn't so much interested in writing radio-friendly songs or songs that chase the radio. I was more interested in writing songs that that would take people out of the everyday moment and put them in this hellish world. My last band, Down Factor, was all political. I wrote about, you know, government, how much I hate the government, and social issues and religion, and I just realized that I wasn't going to change anybody's minds, and whatever I had to bitch about just really didn't matter. So rather than complain, I decided I wanted to write these concept albums, these concept stories. A lot went into the making of this record, from the talent to the studios to the parts of the songs. There's a story. It's dynamic and it's very organic at the same time. I even brought in a 22-piece choir to sing over four of the tracks. There are soundscapes that bridge the songs together. The idea behind From Hell is to make a horror show. Alistair Sin is a character on stage. Meant to put the people in attendance in that hellish atmosphere, in that moment, make you feel like you are part of the story, or make you feel like you are in the show. It's not just a bunch of dudes up on stage rocking out. I also produced this record with Snake, the guitar player from Skin Lab. Snake dedicated a lot of hours, weeks, you know, months working on this project to help me bring it to life. He has a studio in a separate building outside the back of his house, and so we recorded a lot of the record there. We recorded the guitars and the bass and the vocals there.
I look down to see that I am no longer my sight to kill me.
Bennett of the legendary Starship came in and recorded a very beautiful piano track to a song called Dead Reckoning. And then the drums we recorded at Skyline Studios in Oakland, California. Amazing live room there and an awesome array of microphones. We even used a Neve console to capture Paul's drum tone. So without a doubt, we got some of the best drum tones that we could ever hope for.
Hello, I'm Master Paul Bostaph. Just finished up my session with George Anderson's From Hell. Actually, doing the record From Hell with George was really interesting because George has been working on this material for years, and his strong vision of the story he's trying to tell translates into a good horror movie or a really good good novel if you're into that kind of thing. And hanging around with George and doing the rehearsal for the record was pretty cool because not only were we getting to know the material, there was intent to everything. Like some of the songs at first as I was learning them seemed a little repetitive, but there was an intent to everything, and the only way I was really able to kind of help convey the story from my end of things on the drums was to kind of get into George's brain a little bit about what he was trying to achieve. And George was really forthcoming with all that type of information. And you know, some people have an idea of what they want to do for a story and don't tell very good stories, but George did a really good job with the music and wrote some really good riffs. And it's pretty cool. It's like it's kind of fun. It's been a fun, really fun process because each song tells a part of the story, as any good record would, in terms of telling a story, but George did a great job with it.
This is Damien from Death Angel. I'm in the studio with From Hell, featuring George Anderson, Steve Smythe, and Paul Bostaph. The album's gonna feature a lot of metal, a little black metal, a little death metal, a little prog metal. Check it out. Working with Paul Bostaph in the studio, Paul Bostaph. of Slayer, Paul Bostaph. Yeah. So playing with him definitely pushes the level of the musicianship. Like, you know, he's a talented drummer. He's playing a lot of 16th double bass. So right away, like, I know that I'm not going to be able to like get away with like just grooving some notes. Like, I'm going to have to, you know, from the bass standpoint. So that really pushes like what I'm having to do.
Influences that I perceived right away when I started listening to George's material and rehearsing with George, it was definitely like horror movies and like movie soundtrack, like, you know, sci-fi movie soundtracks or horror movie soundtracks, which we started talking about. Like I like a lot of Danny Elfman stuff, I think George even told me himself that he at night he'll go to sleep to movie soundtracks, which I think is pretty cool. So it was definitely George is really into Merciful Fate, you know, so that kind of the King Diamond Merciful Fate thing. And I'm a big Mickey D fan. All those things between the horror movies, between the telling of the story, between, I've never really done a concept record before, so it's really like the first concept record I've done ever. So it was interesting. With knowing all that stuff, that there had to be, other than it just being one song, another song, another song, that, you know, there was always a feeling that we were telling a story.
George had already been jamming with some dudes. So when we came in, he had bass and drums and stuff already on a CD and the songs and the tuning. So then it was just a matter of learning the songs, which was relatively simple. I just got together with George three or four times to learn the riffs and then jammed it out in my own place, which is usually the kind of the easiest way to do it. And then from there, once Paul came in, did like two or three rehearsals, just making sure, it was really just kind of cushion him getting used to the songs, and then it was recording.
How I feel about being involved with Damien and Steve Smythe in a project together, I think it's pretty interesting. And only unfortunate fact we all haven't been in the room at the same time playing together with the material, or even being in the recording studio. We're all, since you know, Damien's doing the Death Angel thing right now, they're writing a record. Steve Smythe has his own project in England he's putting together. And, you know, I just happen to be in the Bay Area, so is George. We're kind of everything's kind of happening, like, you know, in bits and pieces, apart from each other. I think it's gonna be pretty exciting to hear when it's finally all put together. I mean, Damien, we just finished the drums tonight, so I'm loopy as hell, but now Damien's gonna come in and do bass, which I think is gonna be great, because, you know, we've rehearsed a few times together with George, me and Damien, and it's been really cool. Like I said, unfortunately, Steve hasn't been around for that part of the process, but it's kind of hard to commute back and forth from England every day. So I think it's great. I'm excited to hear what it's finally gonna sound like all put together.
The sound I really hear in this project is kind of a combination of like Dead Heart and a Dead World Nevermore, era Nevermore, with like some kind of conspiracy or them King Diamond, which is kind of a weird merge because it's like new metal or whatever. Power metal with King Diamond. But I do hear like kind of the Nevermore, the lowness and that really strong, pulsing, assaulting sound, you know, that they give. So a big difference in the project that I'm doing here, From Hell, which, you know, it's definitely pushing the limits of being just metal. It's almost on the edge of being death metal, but still has the songwriter element, verse, choruses, and things like that. So, you know, one of the big things that's different is it's not thrash metal. Thrash metal, I feel like, really, I feel like all those bass players were finger bass players, you know, like Cliff Burton, Greg Christian, like Frankie from Anthrax, he's another fingers player. Not Dave Ellison, not Tom. But anyways, I feel like the Bay Area thrash, those guys were like really fingers players, and that is a huge part of the thrash sound. So on a project like this, there's times where like I kind of had to like put that aside, and I actually did grab a pick, you know, and I had to like kind of like, for me, what I started thinking of is more like the harder side of Faith No More or Billy Gold would like get the pick in there and really start like getting a helicopter going on his bass for some of the heavier parts in like Malpractice and stuff on the Faith No More second album with Mike Patton. On the Faith No More album, you know, Angel Dust, like Billy Gold gets the pick and really kind of gets that helicopter sound. So in an element like this where it really kind of going for that, I thought, you know, fuck it, you know, I'm going to grab a plectrum too and really get in there and rip away, kind of shred down on the string. And I think it helped achieve a sound that, you know, as much as I'm a fan of the fingers sound, I think it helped achieve a sound that fingers can't get. You know, maybe like kind of like Chris Squire, really whamming away with the pick on the string. So, and then with the low tuning, helped get that fucking growl, you know. So.
None with a gun, motherfucker. What I think people should expect from this record, I think they should expect a really, really good record. George is putting a lot of time and effort into this. A lot of people will cut corners on things. And George is bringing in a choir for this. I mean, like, he could use keyboards and things like that to emulate choir voices and stuff. George is like doing the extra things, like I said, bringing in a choir in this, like the parts where normally you could just hit notes on a keyboard. He's trying to make this, really make his vision come to fruition, and like George is using the best tools possible to make this happen, and I think he's using a lot of organic things, choir, real voices, harpsichord, things like that, you know, as opposed to more fake sound. So I think it's going to make the story a lot more real in terms of you know, getting the crap scared out.
Studios is also where we recorded the 22-piece choir. That was probably one of the coolest moments of my life when I walked into the studio and there were 25 people in the room holding sheet music of something I'd written. it really blew my mind. I was so taken aback. It was just one of the coolest things that ever happened to me. Brian Matheson is the owner of Skyline, and he also sings in a choir.
Okay, let's go for it.
Took the ideas of what I wanted the choir to do, and Brian and I sat down and arranged those in the most appropriate way.
On your feet.
Anyone, just pause all the way through.
Wait, so for the guys, for the lows, so when you come down, I go, I'd like you to just hold that low note, and then have the other voices, the melody over the top.
Okay. So guys, all the men, all the low voices, just stop at the E flat,
and don't move.
And then we picked a date, and we brought the choir in, and they came in and sang these oohs and ahs over the record, give it this creepy horror feel, and I think they just did an awesome job. Do I have plans to tour with these guys? Well, I would love to say yes to that question, but the reality is Paul has rejoined Slayer since recording the record. So that, you know, kind of puts a hiccup in things and makes things take a little bit longer. When Death Angel doesn't have shows and Damien is available, he'll play shows with From Hell. Steve Smythe, of course, is in London. With his new band called One Machine. They just put out an album this past year also called The Distortion of Lies and the Overdriven Truth. You should check that out if you get a chance. Ascent From Hell is available in stores around the country. If you don't see it on the shelf, ask the record store to order it. It is available through their distributor. Or you can buy it online anywhere you buy music and get it on iTunes, Amazon.com, wherever. We also have a lot of cool merch on our website. We have a lot of cool t-shirts up there, some with the album cover. I have a t-shirt with The Walking Dead, another one with the God of Hell on it, of course the band logo. The next record, I'm anxious to get started writing the next record. It's a little hard when you're pretty embroiled in the marketing and pushing of the record once it gets released. There's a lot of work, a lot of back-end work that has to get done, along with playing shows, and there's a lot of preparation for that. So I do hope to get started on it really soon. I have some ideas, nothing concrete just yet, but hopefully I'll have some stuff coming out pretty soon. So until then.
Booyah, motherfucker!